Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today I'm going to do a recipe that isn't necessarily uniquely Canadian, but does use an ingredient that Canadians excel at in making. And no, it's not maple syrup. It's ice wine. So we're going to do kind of a chocolate pudding type thing that is flavored with ice wine. So into this pot, I just put some heavy cream, 35% whipping cream. This is some milk. And I've got this on sort of a medium temperature. I want to bring this up almost to a simmer, but not quite to a simmer. Now, this is ice wine. And it's made here. Several of the wine regions around us make it. This one happens to be from Niagara region, which is just kind of that way, down towards the American border. And if you're not familiar with ice wine, it's a very interesting process. They grow the grapes down in Niagara or in other places in Canada. And usually you would pick the grapes when they're ripe and you would bring them into the winemaking facility and you'd crush them, press them, get the juice. For ice wine, they leave the grapes on after they have matured and they leave them on well into the winter. And so the grape starts to dry out a little bit. And then the grape freezes. And what happens is they will go out and pick them on a really cold night, somewhere around minus 10 to minus 15 degrees Celsius, if not colder. And at that point, the grapes have dried out quite a bit from being left on the vine longer, but they've also frozen. So now the water inside is completely frozen, except for a very small amount of liquid that is highly concentrated with grape flavor and also sugar. And so they actually squeeze the grapes outside so that they never warm up, they never thaw out. The entire process up to that point is outside in the cold, frozen. And so you get this highly concentrated grape juice, really sweet, really sugary, really concentrated grape flavors, and then they carry on with the winemaking process. And what they end up with in the end is something that is really thick and really, really sweet. And you don't drink very much of it. It's something that you drink after dinner. They only put it in these really small bottles. It's something that you sip and you savor and you share and you enjoy. And it can be quite expensive. The process is long and arduous. There's a chance of years where you're not gonna get any at all. And so it's like liquid gold. It is fantastic if you can get your hands on it. So I'm going to add this into the milk. And you don't put very much in because the flavor is super concentrated. Okay, I think this milk is just about up to temperature. It is hot. It's just starting to steam. So I'm going to put in some chopped chocolate. And I'm just going to mix that in. I'm going to turn the heat off. We're just going to let this sit here and let the chocolate melt into the milk and cream. Now, while the chocolate melts into the cream, the milk, and the ice wine, which doesn't take very long at all, it's pretty much already melted, I'm going to whip up these egg yolks. So I have 4 egg yolks in this jug, and I've got a little bit of sugar. Not a whole lot, considering what we're making. And I'm going to whip this until the egg yolks are really light and frothy. Now, these egg yolks have turned a really, really light yellow and they're super thick. If you're wondering if it's thick enough when you're doing this, if you're wondering that, it's not thick enough. You have to go a little bit farther. So I've got the hot or heated chocolate and milk. It's not that hot, but I'm only going to put in a little bit and whip that in. And then put in the rest. Now, I've got this mixed together. You're not really looking to whip it like you were gonna whip a whipped cream or make a mousse. You just wanna make sure that everything is mixed together. And it would probably be a whole lot less messy if you did it in a stand mixer or with a hand whisk. I've got chocolate and cream everywhere around me. Don't make the same mistakes that I do. So I've got some ramekins here, and I'm just going to divide equally, as they say, between the ramekins. And then I'm going to stick it in the fridge for 2, 3, 4 hours until it chills completely and firms up.
Well, hello, Glen. Hello, friends. I've arrived just in time.
A little bit of ice wine and a little chocolate dessert that has ice wine in it.
Oh, that'll add an interesting...
So there you go.
I'm going to start with this. It's definitely something that is a sweet, small treat to have.
That's amazing. I really do like that. Only in a small amount, though, but I really do like that.
Yeah, it is, yeah. A big glass would be too much.
And that's not even the good stuff. I mean, it's good. I shouldn't say that.
No, you shouldn't say that.
It is good, but from that particular winery, that is their lowest priced bottle. And it is amazing. Does that make sense?
Yes, but okay. There are sweeter and...
It's not the $200 bottle. It's the, you know, it's the affordable bottle.
Right.
And it'll go really well with this chocolate, because this is bitter chocolate. And there's ice wine in this. That's really good. I like that. I like that texture.
I'm trying to figure the texture out, because it's not like... it's a little more dense than a mousse.
Mm-hmm. So this is... it's just chocolate, milk, cream, ice wine, egg yolks. There's no thickening agent. There's no jello, gelatin. And you don't whip the cream into a froth.
That would explain why there's no bubbles.
Yeah.
Why it's more of a creamy than an airy.
Yeah. The texture is amazing.
But you know what's funny is I don't think I can eat the whole container. It is so rich.
Oh no. No, so I tried to make 8 of these containers. And of course I overpoured. So I only got 7.5. So control your pour. But I could have easily cut those in half and made 12. It is something I think that just like the ice wine, it's just a little taste after the end of the meal.
Wow, they really go well together.
Super well together, don't they?
They really complement one another.
Now I've used ice wine. You could use pretty much any, this is the pinnacle, but you could pretty much use any sweet dessert wine.
So something like a Gewürztraminer or...
Or even a Gewürztraminer would work.
I know that
one's really
not super, super sweet, not but super, it's sweet.
It is a sweet wine. It would do really well. So any sort of dessert, sweet dessert wine or a Gewürztraminer, a Vin Santos would work really well.
Mm.
I'm just going to keep shoveling this in, even though I know
even
it's
little
too
bits,
much.
Yeah, it's rich and creamy. Yeah. It's very delicate. Decadent.
It is very decadent.
Not delicate, but decadent.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.